whole universe is synchronized. The house is synchronized. Everything's working on daily basis.
Now you're sitting in front of me,
your heart is beating without your control. Yeah. Your temperature goes up whenever you are, where are you?
It's not design, it's coincidence.
How come? It doesn't make sense.
No, it's not the earthquake.
But he believes that the earthquake can make him a cup of tea.
It does make sense. Yeah, it does make sense.
How come?
Yeah. Tell me.
Your heart and your
can you stop your heart like that?
Because evolution led to my heart. Yeah, like I evolved from animals that had hearts before. And they had hearts before, and then the monkey they evolved from had a heart, and you know the creature they evolved from had a heart, and that's
so order
why my
can come
heart
from,
now is
order
worse.
Can come from randomness, no intention, and so on.
For instance,
yes.
Order can come from
that. Yeah.
Order can come from. And the only example that you can demonstrate from real life is the one that has been disputed. We have no examples in any lab where you can get order from randomness.
Is evolution in dispute?
Right, in this conversation.
Of course.
Wait, evolution is in dispute?
Does everyone believe in evolution? Does everyone believe in evolution?
Hold on.
You don't know what I believe in. But I'm saying, does everyone believe in evolution? No.
Does everyone?
Well, like,
no.
Not everyone.
So, evolution is disputed. Because
not really, not in the scientific community.
No?
Of course it is.
Scientists
are there who don't believe in evolution.
You don't think so?
Maybe there are a few, but like,
one person
if you were to take a survey of all people who have a PhD,
okay. It sounds like, unfortunately, in this situation, guys, I suggest, just by hearing this much here, go home and double check what you're stating, because you'll find a large community of the scientists in the world do not take evolution as a fact. Now that's what you're trying to state.
There are the moths,
guys. You need to go and check how many forms of evolution there are.
It was in England.
You're standing on thin ice, believe me, when you state that.
They would pollute, and the white moths went extinct.
Did you examine this?
They couldn't hide in the coal.
Did you examine this properly? If you have, then you would have even been saying this. The number of the species, it didn't because they die out, because what we call, like, if you can see yourself in a tree, then you are more prone to the predators, right?
Yeah.
Isn't it? So, if you go and examine
so those ones die. That's evolution.
No.
The ones that are easy to eat and kill die.
Look, do you remember this story? I'm going to just turn it backwards a little bit. The giraffe, story of the giraffe.
I don't know the story of the giraffe.
Lamarckism.
No.
You know what? The giraffe has long neck because, so you had species there, they were competing the food on the bottom layer, right? So the food's gone from the bottom layer. So you need food on the upper layer of the trees.
Yeah.
So they started growing longer and longer necks. But they didn't realize one of the fallacy of this reasoning is that, what about the baby giraffes? Because giraffes don't feed their babies and so on, they're going to die out anyway, so the babies won't grow, so there'll be no more giraffes in the first place. So the idea that giraffes have longer necks because of this, this is like this thing again, the story of the moth. You know the experiment about the Drosophila? That we have done so many experiments with Drosophila changing its genes. You have half a wing, lesser wing, and so on. The Drosophila is still a fruit fly. You cannot go beyond the boundary of species. The species of boundary. How many times you breed a dog? Still a dog. You don't get a pet out of it.
Over on a period of millions of years.
No, that's a belief. Over a period of millions of years.
Like dogs and baboons have a common ancestor.
Right?
Dogs and baboons have a common ancestor.
I want to ask this question. Over millions of years, billions of years later, is it possible that you can become a cockroach?
Yes.
Then perhaps you need to go back and deeply reflect on the science and the mechanisms of how things happen.
No,
you affirm at one point that evolution is what? Not devolution, it's evolution.
Right.
And then you become a cockroach.
Necessarily going forward, it's a thing that just happens.
Adapting to an environment.
Yeah.
Just happens, it's not science.
An explanation of just happens is not science, is it?
This is magic.
God did it. It's a mechanism.
You know what?
It's
one of these would say, God did it. It just is. You would not accept that.